In the second thread group, I've added one transaction controller and there are two APIs been added into it. The configuration settings of transaction controller is that it has one generate parent sample checkbox and one include duration of timer and pre-post processor in generate sample. So by default, this generate parent sample checkbox is unchecked, which means you will get individual response time of both these APIs. If you check this generate parent sample, then what will happen? You will get a combined response time of both these APIs in your run. So let me run this thread group to show you both the cases. So now I have ticked this generate parent sample, which means I should get a combined response time. So now you can see the response time of API 1 and response time API 2 is added and it is being shown over here, 2491. If I uncheck this and then run the same thread group, then I get individual response time of both the APIs. So this was the difference between generate parent sample. By default, this include checkbox is unchecked, which means additional duration of timer and processors will not be added into your response time. If you check this checkbox, then the duration of timer and processor will be added to your response time. So let me comment this. The third controller is loop controller, in which I have added these two APIs. In configuration settings, there are two options. Either you can do infinite loop of these two APIs, or you can specify a particular number, say 10, and accordingly, these two APIs will get executed. So if I have specified 10 over here, these two APIs will get executed for 10 times. So it works as such that if in my thread group I have specified 1 and in my loop controller I have specified 10. So anything above this loop controller, it will get executed one time, and anything below this loop controller will get executed one time. And my loop controller, as I have specified 10 over here, it will get executed 10 times. So this is the use of loop controller. So if you are having something in your script and you want to execute for a defined number of times, so you can use a loop controller in your script.